Hi everybody, this is Bob Kramer. I'm back in the garage again. Well, I wanted to show you the outcome of the rewiring project on the 1983 Goldwing. So, this is the 83 Goldwing, and I've completely rewired the bike. One of my previous videos showed the wiring harness under construction. So, right here there's a terminal block there for the tail lights and turn signals. I created a grounding bus out of a piece of number 12 gauge wire. And so then all the ground connections are connected to that 12 gauge wire, which is then in turn connected to the battery. And so anyway, that's that. And then this is the wiring harness, all wrapped up in cloth wire loom. It's got a new voltage regulator. And then these are the spark igniters I created. And then this is the Moto Gadget M unit. This replaced all the other electronic components that were on this bike, including the fuse box. So I'm going to turn on the ignition key, and you can see what this M unit does when you turn it on. You see that it's testing the circuits, and then it lights up, okay? And this controls all the electrical functions of the bike. So now, if I hit the start button, you'll see it'll start up. See there, it started up. I'm gonna kill it, but anyway, I don't want to run it inside the garage. But now the M unit's all lit up, and it thinks that the bike is running now. So the headlight is on, and so the big advantage to this M unit is that you don't need as much wire. So on the left side, there's six less wires than there was with the OEM system. And as you can see, we now have push buttons where it used to be switches. So this push button turns on the turn signal. Push it again, it turns it off. And there's a an alarm notification telling me that the engine is dead, but the ignition is still on. So I'm gonna see if we can cancel that. Okay. So anyway, the high beam switch is now not a switch, but just a push button. You push it to go to high beam, push it again, go back to low beam. Okay. Also, because there's less wires, I was able to put all the wiring inside the handlebar. There's no wiring outside the handlebar. And that includes the wires for the grip heaters. I put those in the handlebar too. So all the wires are exiting the handlebar down here. The red switch on there is a switch for the grip heaters. That turns the heaters on and off. And then next to that right here is a USB port to plug in a cell phone. And then on the other side we have the start button as before, and then we have the right side turn signal. Again, there's about five less wires than there used to be. The start button does double duty as a kill switch. You no longer need a kill switch. If the engine's running, when you double tap the start button, it kills the engine. So anyway, that's what we've done with this M unit. It does a lot of cool things. Oh, it also enables you to start the bike without the key. So when you're going down the road, you don't have to have your key fob flapping in the wind and taking the paint off of the handlebar clamp. So it'll have a keyless start feature because it's Bluetooth connected to your phone. If you get on the bike and you have your phone in your pocket, you can just push the start button and go. When you park the bike and walk away from it, as soon as your cell phone gets out of range, it will automatically set an alarm system. The alarm system will turn on your flashers and honk the horn if somebody starts tampering with your bike. So anyway, that's what we've got. So I hope you like the video. I hope you like the project. I'm getting ready to move on to my next project, which is over here. I picked this up the other day from a gentleman over in Lyman, South Carolina. It's an interesting story on this bike. This is a 1980 Honda Goldwing, and a grandfather used to ride this, and he parked it 10 years ago, and now he has given it to his grandson, and his grandson has commissioned me to recondition the bike and make it roadworthy again after it's sat in his grandpa's shed for the last 10 years.